Welcome back to TenorShare, everyone. Have you guys met the issue that your iPad suddenly stuck on the white screen? Don't know how and don't know why, it is annoying. So I check it out, and I find out 3 ways to fix iPad white screen. Now I will show you how. Method 1. Force restart to fix iPad white screen. For iPad with a home button, press and hold both power button and home button. Keep holding till the Apple logo shows up. For iPad without a home button, press the volume up and press the volume down, and then press and hold the power button. Keep holding till the Apple logo shows up. Then you can check if the white screen issue is gone or not. If not, follow the next method to fix your iPad system. Method 2. Repair iPad white screen with Reiboot, no data loss. This is an iOS device repair tool. It can fix more than 150 iOS system issues, so it can fix iPad white screen. Check the download link in the description if you are interested. Once installed, connect your iPad to your PC or Mac, and then open Reiboot. Click the green start button. Do standard repair. Here we'll need to download firmware to fix your iPad. Click download. The download process will not be long, depending on your network condition. Once download is okay, click start repair button. Then it will start to repair your iPad frozen screen issue. This process will take a while, relax and be patient. As the process is done, you can see my iPad white screen issue disappears. I can access my iPad without any problem, and none of my data is lost. Go try it! If you prefer to use iTunes, follow the next method. Method 3. Update iPad with iTunes or Finder. Open iTunes or Finder, connect your iPad to it. Then we need to put your iPad in recovery mode. For iPad with a home button, press and hold both power button, home button. Keep holding till the recovery mode screen shows up. For iPad without a home button, press the volume up and press the volume down, and then press and hold the power button. Keep holding till the recovery mode screen shows up. Then you should see iTunes or Finder pop up a window. Choose update here. iTunes or Finder will begin to download firmware. Once the firmware is okay, it will start to update your iPad. Because it takes me a long time, so I will skip the process. Now you can see my iPad is back to the normal state. The white screen issue is gone, but it is not working every time, so I recommend method 2. Okay, that's it. Hope this video is helpful to you. I'll be grateful if you subscribe. See you guys next time.